viewers, today's topic of discussion is hernia. Hernia is an abnormal weakness or hole in an anatomical structure which allows something inside to protrude through. Hernia is protrusion of an organ or the muscular wall of an organ through the cavity that normally contains it. It is an abnormal protrusion of the intestine or other abdominal organ through the weakness or defect in the musculature into another cavity. Or we can define it in another way, a condition in which part of an organ is displaced and protrudes through the wall of the cavity containing it, often involving the intestine at a weak point in the abdominal wall. The most important elements in the development of a hernia are congenital or muscle weakness and increased of the abdominal pressure. Now let's understand the causes for the hernia. Any condition that is increasing the pressure on abdominal cavity will result in hernia. Combination of muscle weakness and strain. Obesity is also a cause. Heavy lifting, persistent coughing or sneezing, pregnancy, straining during bowel movements or urination, constipation, damage from injury or surgery, chronic cough, congenital defect, heavy weight lifting, constipation, obesity, pregnancy, smoking and muscle weakness are the risk factors. Now classification. Hernia is classified into inguinal hernia, hiatal hernia, femoral hernia, umbilical hernia, incisional hernia, epigastric hernia, obturator hernia, herniation of intervertebral and ventral hernia. Inguinal hernia occurs in the groin, the area between the abdomen and thigh. It is called inguinal because the intestine pushed through a weak spot in the inguinal cavity, which is a triangle-shaped opening between the layers of abdominal muscles near the groin. Type of inguinal hernia are indirect and direct. Direct inguinal hernia. It passes through a weak point in the fascia of abdominal wall and at the middle to the inferior epigastric artery. Indirect inguinal hernia. Muscle weakness at the inguinal ring causes failure closure of the deep inguinal ring when increased intra-abdominal pressure and dilatation of inguinal ring allow abdominal contents to enter the channel. The protrusion passes through the deep inguinal ring and is located lateral to the inferior epigastric artery. So in direct inguinal hernia, hernia occurs within the floor of Hasselbeck's triangle, that is the hernia sac does not traverse the internal ring. Herniation occurs directly through the abdominal wall. Whereas in indirect inguinal hernia, the hernial sac enters the inguinal canal through the deep inguinal ring lateral to the inferior epigastric vessels. It may extend part of the way along the canal as far as the superficial inguinal ring. It is congenital in origin and it is the most common form of hernia. The hernial sac is remains of processus vaginalis. Signs and symptoms of hernia are bulging, tenderness, pain when lifting heavy objects. Small to moderate size hernia don't usually cause any symptoms, but large hernia may be noticeable and cause some discomfort. There is severe and sudden pain along with nausea, vomiting and constipation. This is the picture showing the grading of hernia. When skin of the abdominal wall gets weakens and when intestine pushes into sac and when intestine become trapped. In fourth picture you can see when intestine becomes strangulated. Lump at an appropriate anatomical site is seen and it increases in size on coughing or straining. It reduces in size or disappear when relaxed or supine position. Local examination is must and it should be exposed from umbilicus up to the mid-thigh. Examine first in standing position, then in supine position. Inspection is done to check the swelling, size, shape, position and extent of hernial sac. Visible peristalsis is seen and there is impulse on coughing, that is very important sign of hernia. Treatment of hernia in infants is herniotomy. In adults, herniotomy is done where the excision of hernial sac along with herniorrhaphy is done. Hernioplasty is the second procedure where the stenting of the posterior wall of the inguinal canal is done by using mesh. Mesh is fixed inferiorly to lacunar and inguinal ligament, medially to overlap rectus sheet and fixed to fascia over the pubic bone.